Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. It was a long cherished dream to visit this sanctuary for bird photography. It is situated in the Himalayan foothills in Arunachal Pradesh in the West Kameng district. More than 450 species of birds have been reported from Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. We started our journey from Mumbai airport in the early morning. We plan to stay at Lama Camp and Bompu Camp in the Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. We reached in the morning around 9:30 a.m. to Guwahati Airport and straight away started our journey to the dumping ground. Our target species was the endangered greater adjutant, which is found in the dumping ground of Guwahati. There are only two places where it is found in India. One is in Bhagalpur, Bihar, and another one is in Guwahati. We clicked some beautiful images of this bird. Huge bird. From there, we started our journey to the Lama camp. Entering into Arunachal Pradesh need special pass. The roads were in good condition in Arunachal Pradesh with scenic beauty, lush green jungles. On the route, we did some birding. We got white-throated bulbul, white-drum shama, great myna, Asian fairy bluebird, and many more other birds like green magpie, a few warblers. On the road to Lama camp, we got grey nightjar. We reached Lama camp in the evening at around 7:30 p.m. Had dinner and then we slept. We started our day 5:30 a.m. in the morning. And our targeted species were Trogons, Tragopan, Bugun Leo Chichila, which is endemic to Eagle Nest only. Soon we got a flock of bullfinch, a mixed flock of grey and red-headed bullfinch, female bullfinch, grey-headed bullfinch, male. We got some excellent friends, and then golden-naped finch, male and female. We also got maroon-back accenter and parrotbill, greater rufous-headed parrotbill. We continued birding around Lama camp for 2 days, and then next day we travels towards Bompu camp, which is around 36 km away from the Lama camp, and it passes through highest point Eagle Nest Pass. On the way we did some birding, Eagle Nest Pass, rough conditions of the road. We captured fire-tailed Mysornis on the floor and posing for the camera. Green-tailed Sunbird, Mrs. Gould Sunbird, and fire-tailed sunbird. We continued our journey and reached Bompu camp. Next day, we started our day early in the morning. We started birding at around 5 a.m. in the morning. Weather was good. A lush green jungle. And our target species were trogons. We spent many hours searching these beautiful birds. There are two type of trogons found in eagle nest, wasp trogon and red-headed trogon. And soon we were lucky to have our first catch, wasp trogon, male-female, on a very good perch. Soon we got another catch, green cachua. We had lunch in the forest itself. What could be the better way to finish a day filled with exploring the woods, clicking beautiful bird pictures, and then sitting beside the campfire in the night, in the chilling cold, reviewing the images, ghost stories, chatting with friends, and then sleeping in a tent beneath a pitch black sky filled with bright stars. So we started the next day early again. Next day morning, it was raining, but still we ventured out for the birding. It was intermittent rains. Nothing is more beautiful than the loveliness of woods. Those lush green beauties are the most peaceful scene to the eye. When the rain was stopped, we continued birding. Bird calls fill the atmosphere. Sometimes we need the fog to remind ourselves that all of life is not black and white. It is an old saying about fog that beyond the fog lies clarity. Soon we reached Khelong, which is on the other side of Bampo camp. We had lunch here at the forest rest house. We saw red-headed trogon here, and then few more birds like white-hooded babbler, adult, and juvenile white-hooded babbler. A wasp trogon female. Barving wren babbler. Rufous fronted wren babbler and scaly wren babbler, beautiful sepia pair, rufous gorgated flycatcher, mountain tailor bird, slaty bellied tessia, blackface warbler, rufous gorgated flycatcher. Soon it was raining heavily with deteriorated light for the photography. We continued our search, but visibility was very much poor. Soon leeches were everywhere, and in Himalayan regions one should always take precautions for leeches, because the rain can start at any moment and then leeches can be a problem. Soon we were out on the trail, although visibility was poor, but we still enjoyed the rainforest
in the fog. It was a thrilling experience to walk through the rainforest in search of birds, hearing their calls, and then trying to click. Soon we click golden fronted barbet as well as blue throated barbet. We got fire breasted flower picker and a pygmy blue flycatcher, which was a life form for me. As well as we got red vented Euhina, mountain teller bird, a green striped babbler, and various warblers. On fifth day, we traveled to Dirang and from there to the Sangati Valley. Our target species was long-billed plover. It was a beautiful landscape. We got long-billed plover. We got on the way a sparrowhawk, and surprisingly, its tail was cut. A plumbeous red star. On sixth day, we traveled to Sela Pass. We started at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's around 50 km from Dirang, a beautiful scenic place. Our target species were blood pheasant. We were in search of few high altitude birds like grandala, rose finches, it's a beautiful place. Sela Pass connects Tawang district to the Dirang district. We got white-throated rose finch, male as well as female. Grandala, grandala male and female, rosy pipit, a rufous fronted teat, a golden eagle pair in the sky, and then again a much awaited lifer, brown throated dipper. And then blood pheasant. We got beautiful frame of this dream bird and we were quite happy. After 2-3 hours of trek, we got this bird and it was a successful tour at Sela Pass. The next day we traveled to Nameri for clicking white-winged wood duck, which is a state bird of Assam. We need to cross the river and then 2.5 km trek inside the jungle for the white-winged duck, wood duck. On the way, we got few birds like red-breasted parakeet, pinstripe babbler, velvet-fronted nuthatch, lineated barbet, and many more. We continue our journey Finally, we got a record shot of white-winged wood duck, which flew away as soon as we approached it. Then we got red-breasted parakeet, golden-capped langur. And then we started our journey back to Guwahati. So in 8 days, we recorded 160 species of the birds, and the highlights were wardstone and bloodfish. Thank you for watching.